Hey guys, this is Dr. Sangeeta. Welcome back to another episode of Dental Paathshala, and today's topic is the anatomy of the premolars and the molars, which is an important topic. So let's jump into it. Before we get started, make sure you subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon. That way you get a notification as soon as I release a video lecture now talking about the anatomy of the pulp chamber. So today's video we are going to cover with the rest of the anatomy. So we have left with the premolars and the molars, which we are going to cover in the today's video. Already we have talked about the anatomy of the pulp chamber of the anterior teeth for maxilla and mandible, and also the excess cavity preparation we have talked about. So coming to the excess cavity preparation, coming to the anatomy of the pulp cavity for first premolar. Now all of the premolars have only one root except the maxillary first premolar, which has two roots. And in premolars, the mandibular first premolar is the complex one. So we'll talk about one by one. Coming to the maxillary first premolar, we have two pulp horns under each of the cusps. So there are two cusps in the maxillary first premolar, and two roots, one in the buccal and one in the palatal, or we can say one in the lingual. So there are two pulp horn under each of the cusp, and the buccal horn is prominent as the buccal root is prominent. So if we look at the maxillary first premolar, so this is how maxillary first premolar is. The biggest root is our buccal root, so the buccal pulp horns are prominent as compared to the lingual pulp horns, and there are the orifice of the first premolar look like a kidney shape. So we look at the orifice, that is the kidney shape, or we can say elliptical. So this is a elliptical. If we look at the floor of the pulp chamber, the orifices look like this, and excess cavity is more like an ovoid excess cavity. So there are two roots, and there are two canals, two roots and two canals. Now these canals are present, one in the buccal and one in the palatal region, and palatal region is the largest canal. So the canal of the palatal is the largest, and buccal is, there may be more than one canal. So there are two canals, one in the buccal, one in the palatal, and again in the buccal, other than one, there may be an extra canal, but that is rare, that is not always. So if we look at the rare chances, we may have three canals, and these canal may be a palatal canal, mesiobuccal canal, and we can also have a distobuccal canal, because buccal we can have two canals. So the buccal canal is below the buccal cusp, and the palatal canal is below the palatal cusp. So this is, if this is the buccal cusp, the buccal canal is below the buccal cusp, and the palatal canal is below the palatal cusp, because it follows the anatomy. And the root canals are straight line and divergent. So the root canals are basically straight line. So there is no difficulty in making a straight line excess for maxillary first premolar, if we talk about. Coming to the maxillary second premolar. Now they have two pulp horns, and the buccal pulp horn is larger, same as the maxillary first premolar. And the orifices and the pulp floor are same as the first premolar. They are elliptical, and they can be elliptical and kidney shape also. But the shape is less. If we compare with the maxillary first molar, so maxillary first molar has a typical kidney shape. A typical kidney shape or typical elliptical orifice. So talking about the maxillary second premolar, the canal looks more like a ribbon shape. So the ribbon shape canal, we can say. So these maxillary second premolar have one root. So every premolars except the maxillary first premolar had two roots. So one root, one canal, and one foramina, which is a vertusi type 1, right? So this is the maxillary second premolar. This is normally, but this is usually, but there may be a situation which is the type 2 vertusi. Now type 2 vertusi is one pulp chamber which is divided into two foramina. So what it can be, one root, two canal, and again two foramina. So this can be also seen in the maxillary second premolar, but usually most of the times one root, one canal, and one foramina is seen. And also there are lateral canals which are visible in the second premolar, and 59% of the canal have lateral canals in the second premolar and 1.6% in the furcation area, while if we look at the lateral canals, 59.5%, so more than 50% there are the lateral canals which are present in the maxillary second premolar. If we talk about the mandibular first premolar, now mandibular first premolar is the most complex. Now to understand this, first you should remember the vertusi classification. If you remember the vertusi classification, which we have already covered, now I'm just going to write it one so that in this video it is easier for us. So 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 and 8. So 1, 2, 3 ends at 1. So this is going to be 1, 1 and 1. So I'm going to write 2 here, 2, and then I'm going to write again 1. So 4 is the 2. From 4 to 7 it is 2. So this is 2 and 8th one is 3. So 2, then this is 2, 4th one is 2. 5th I'm going to write 1 and then 1 and then 2 and then 1, 2 and 1. So this is our vertusi classification. So coming to the mandibular first premolar, now the mandibular first premolar is ovoid in shape. The excess cavity is ovoid in shape, buccolingually. And there is usually one short conical root, but the root may divide, may furcate. There may be furcation present in the apical area. We have already covered also in the anterior that the bifurcated root are most commonly seen in the mandibular first premolar. The most common is seen in the mandibular first premolar, and second most common bifurcated root are seen in the mandibular incisors, and third most common is the mandibular canine, which we have covered in the anterior part. So coming again back to the mandibular first premolar, now we have one root most of the times. But we may have bifurcations present in the apical third of the root. And if we talk about the one root, there are 48% chances that this root is straight line. And there are rest of the 35%, there is going to be a distal curvature in the root. So this is the distal curvature, as we all know that there is a distal inclination of the root. And if we talk about the canal, now 70% of the time it is going to be vertusi class 1. So vertusi class 1 is our one canal and one foramina. And rest of the 24% it is vertusi type 2, which is two from the pulp chamber, they are coming as two and they are uniting back and exiting as one from a one foramen. One apical foramen. Now coming to this is a type 2. Type 2 is 24%, and if we look at the type 3 vertusi, which is our from the pulp chamber, it is 1, then it is diverging into 2 and then merging back into the 1 and leaving from the canal as 1. So this is our type 3 vertuses, which is seen in the, if we look at the mandibular first premolar, now this type 3 is seen in 4% of the cases. In the 4% cases of the mandibular first premolar. And if we look at the type 4 vertusi, which is the two canals which are leaving from the two foramens, and this two canals is seen, the type 4 vertusi is seen in 1.5%. So this is decreasing. As you can see, we are going vertusi from top to bottom. Now this ratio is increasing. In type 1 vertusi, it is 70%. We are talking about the mandibular first premolar. And 24% in the type 2. And third, it is 4%. And fourth, it is 1.5%. And then we'll come to the eighth one, which are the three canals, and this is 0.5%. So this is about the canals, extra canals, but most of the time the one with one canal, one foramen, one root. So this is seen in the 70% of the cases. Most of the cases it is one root, one canal and one foramina, but there is variation which is seen. Now coming to the mandibular second premolar, this is similar to the mandibular first premolar, except our lingual pulp horns, which are more prominent in the mandibular second premolar, and usually there is one root which is seen, but again there may be a bifurcation which may be seen at the apical third of the root, and this one root is most of the time there is a distal inclination of this one root. Now this distal inclination is seen in, if we look at the second premolar, it is 40%. and straight line is 39%. So there is usually a distal inclination which is present. So the tips to remember from the premolars is that if we look at the maxillary first premolar, the shape of the orifice is kidney shape or elliptical. Now only the first premolar or in all of the premolars are two canal and three. There are two roots and three canal. Three canals, but usually there are two roots and two canals seen, but there may be three canal seen. And if we look at the maxillary second premolar, now in the maxillary second premolar, we have lateral canals which are visible in 59.5% of the cases. And lateral canals are actually, the BMP can be done with the help of irrigation. So we are going to clean these canals with the help of, we cannot use files because files can't go in the lateral canal. So with the help of irrigation, we are going to clean these canals. If we look at the mandible of first premolar, and there is usually one root, one canal, one foramina, which is Vertusi class 1, which is in 70% of the cases. And if we look at the Vertusi type 2, which is 24% cases seen. If we look at the Vertusi type 3, which is 4%, and type 4, which is 1.5%, and type 8, which is 0.5%. If you have not watched the Vertusi classification video, I highly recommend you to watch that video, because you don't have to remember anything in the Vertusi classification if you look at the videos in which we have all covered all the classifications. So coming to the molars, first we are going to cover the first and second molar for maxilla and mandible, because third molar, the anatomy of pulp chamber is same. So looking at the maxillary first molar, now the maxillary first molar has three roots and three canals, and this is usually, so three canals are present in both the canals and the root. So it is the palatal, which is the biggest root. Palatal root is the biggest root for maxilla as well as for for first and as well as for second molar. So palatal root, and there is one more, mesiobuccal and distobuccal root. So buccally, if we look at the buccal side, there are two roots, the mesiobuccal and the distobuccal. And if we look at the lingual side, so palatally there is one more root. So palatal root is the biggest root. And the cuspal outline for maxillary first molar is rhomboid. So this is our cuspal outline if we join all these cusps. And also there is a cusp of Caribelli which is present in the lingual region. So mesiolingual region, there is a cusp of Caribelli also, but that is not significant for us. So there are four cusps, right? So these four cusps, there are four pulp horns also. So the roof of the pulp is rhomboid in shape, and there are three roots. Palatal, mesiobuccal, distobuccal, and three canals, palatal, mesiobuccal, distobuccal. Now if we look at the mesiobuccal canal, this mesiobuccal canal is the largest canal. This is, we are talking about the canal. And also there may be sometimes fourth canal also present in the mesiobuccal canal. Now in the mesiobuccal root, now if you look at this mesiobuccal root, there may be a small here, there may be a fourth canal also present in the palatal side. So the axis cavity, this is the axis cavity, this is triangular. So and with the apex at the palatal region and base at the mesiobuccal and the distobuccal. And it doesn't cross the oblique line. So if we look at the axis cavity preparation, once we look at, so this oblique line is not crossed in the axis cavity preparation. And also there are some lateral canals present in the apical area as well as in the Furcation area. Now once we look at the second molar, also the second molar also has the longest palatal root and similar to the first molar. But there are the mesiodistally, the second molar is actually narrower. And if we look at the roof of the pulp chamber, again it is rhomboidal. So the anatomy of the axis cavity is again triangular for the second molar also. And there are three roots which are present and three canals which are present also in the maxillary second molar. So three roots and three canals. But there are lateral canals are less if we compare the maxillary first molar and the maxillary second molar. So there are less canals, less lateral canals and less divergent root. Now talking about the mandible of first molar, if we look at the mandible of first molar, it is trapezoid. So the excess cavity is trapezoid, but in case if four canals are present, these are the three canals, but in case extra fourth canal is present, which is in the distal, we'll talk about. So if the fourth canal is present, then it becomes the rectangular, and this is a rhomboid pulp chamber. There are four pulp horns and there are two roots. Now the mandibular both. For the maxilla, there are three roots for molars, and for mandibular, there are two roots. But the canal are going to vary, you know it very well. So, two roots and three canals. Now, these three canals are present where? Mesial, two in the mesial, And because we have two roots, right? So all, if you remember, in the maxillary first molar root, so the extra canal was present in the mesiobuccal root. So the third canal is, so there are two canals which are going to be present in the mesial root, and in the distal root there is going to be one canal. This is normal for mandibular first molar, and rare chances are that there is one more extra canal which is present in distal, because distal already had only one, right? So there may be one extra canal which is present in the distal side, and there are 30% chances that this fourth canal is going to be present in the mandibular first molar. And if we look at the maxillary first molar, the fourth canal, that the chances of having fourth canal in the mesiobuccal root are 40%. So 40% for the fourth canal. And if we look at the mandibular first molar, 30% chances of the third canal in the distal root. So coming to the mandibular second molar, this is smaller as we compare with the first molar, and as you all know, the excess cavity is going to be similar. So this is also a trapezoid excess cavity with the two roots and three canals. Again, same. So if you remember, for the maxillary, three roots and three canal for both of the maxillary molar, the usual I'm talking about. And if we look at the mandibular, the usual are two roots and three canals. So the two roots and three canals, this is the usual present. And if we look at unusual cases, then there are not two roots present. The unusual cases, if we look, 71% of the time two roots are present. This is the usual. And 27% chances are there that there is only one root present in the mandibular second molar. And there are 2% chances that there are three roots present in the mandibular second molar. So let's go through molar once again. So if we talk about the maxillary molar, the cavity, the pulp roof is going to be rhomboid, and there are three roots and three canals. So mesiobuccal, distobuccal and palatal. And if in case fourth canal is present, then it is present in the mesiobuccal root. And there are also lateral canals which are present, and excess cavity is triangular shape. If we look at the orifices, then that is rhomboid. So coming to the second molar, it is same as the maxillary first molar, but it is similar to, but it is narrower. The mesiodistally it is narrower. So three roots and three canals are present. Roots are less divergent and there are less lateral canals which are present. Coming to the mandibular first molar. Now mandibular first molar, the excess cavity trapezoid of three canals are present, right? Because the both of mandibular molars are two roots and three canals. Two roots and three canals. So the roots are mesial root and the distal root. And if we talk about mesial root, we have two canals usually. And extra canal, if fourth canal is present, then it is present in the distal root, because distal root had one canal. So the mandibular first molar, and which is 30% chances that there is a fourth canal which is found. That is usually the fourth canal is also, if we look at, we can find the fourth canal also. Coming to the mandibular second molar, now the mandibular second molar usually have two roots and three canals like the mandibular first molar. But there are 71% chances that we have the second two roots and the third three canals. And there are 27% chances that we are going to have one root in the mandibular second molar. And there are 3% chances that we are, 2% chances that we are going to have three roots in the mandibular second molar. Talking about the maxillary third molar, most of the time there are fused root present, but if independent roots are present, then there may be four or more than four independent roots. And there are three canal orifices most of the time, but we may have four or five. And we all know that third molar is the most congenitally missing or malformed teeth, and the longer roots are present and shorter crown if we look at the maxillary third molar, because it is easier to anesthetize for the longer root. Now the roots are fused, there may be one conical root if fused root are present, and if independent roots are present, then there may be four roots. And if we look at the root, it can may be straight, curved. Basically the thing to remember for the third molar is the C shape. So the pulp chamber is going to be C shape, as well as the root canal is also going to be C shape for as maxilla as well as for the mandibular third molar. So that is the reason we have talked third molar in the end. So mandibular third molar also have two roots and two canals most of the time, but rarely it may be one root and one canal, or three root and three canal. But most of the time it is two roots and two canals, and also there is a C shape root canal orifice which is present in the mandibular third molar. So this finishes the anatomy of the pulp cavity. We have already covered the anterior, and this video we have covered the premolars and the molars. And if you feel that you have learned something new today, or I have made it easier for you, then go ahead and hit the comment box and the like button. And And it helps me to help you with your career, with your knowledge while you stay at home with your family. See you soon. Stay safe.